Hi guys, it's Otto here from Tron.com. Today I'm going to show you how to wire up the Izimo IO receiver module for roller shutters. So I'm going to connect it to the motor and I'm going to test to see if it all works. Because nobody really wants to read a manual, right? You just want to see a video of how it's done. So let's go! So what do you need? You need a few things. First of all, of course, power cord or connection to mains power, preferably switched off while you're working. You're going to need a connector to connect the wires from the motor, the receiver module and the power cord. I'm using these because I think they're very convenient, but you can use whichever ones work for you. And of course, I need the motor and the Izimo module. We're wiring the whole system up without using a switch. You can also use a switch, but in this case, we're not going to use that. So I'm going to show you the method and the way the wires need to be connected when you're not using a switch. So keep that in mind. So I'm going to take the Izimo module. And as you can see, there are a few different wires coming out. And you'll see that these with the M are going to be the ones that need to be connected to the motor. And you have here, you have the ones that are going to be connected to the power cord. And the blue is going to be connected to the motor. So let's go and have a look. So first I'm going to take the ones for the motor. I'm going to remove these little socks. I'm going to take the wires of the motor. So it's very straightforward. I'm going to match black to black. So we'll have black in here. So that's one done. We have the black of the motor connected to the module. Next up is brown. Just put them in the connector. So brown goes in here. And we're going to close this. And then we have brown and black connected. So the motor is now almost done. So now the power cord. And so blue is going to be connected. And here I'm going to use a connector with more openings. So the power cord is now connected to the Izimo. Next is brown. Use a different connector. And brown goes in here. Close these. So now we have the blue and brown wires from mains power connected. And we have brown and black of the motor connected. That's where we are now. What still needs to be done is blue needs to be connected as well, because of course we have to feed the motor. And I'm going to add this here to this larger connector block. So we have all the three blue wires connected. One is going to the Izimo module, one is going to the power cord, and one is going to the motor. So that's done. Now, for safety, we're going to connect these two as well. So this is the one from the power cord. This is going to the motor. And it bypasses the module. So my last little connector block. I'm going to push that in. So again, you see that all wires are now connected. These two, we're not going to use them because they're used for a switch. We have the brown one, the black one, earth, and then we have, again, the blue wires and the brown. So everything's connected now. So let's give it a test. I'm going to plug in my mains power. So that's in. So we have the program button here. And by pushing it, I can make it roll up and down and stop. So let's test it. You can see move, stop, press again, moves the other direction, press again, it stops. So that's it, it's working. So that's the way to wire up the Izimo receiver module if you're not going to use a switch. We'll see in further videos how you can, for example, connect it to Tahoma. And for now, if you have any questions, let me know. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.